saw at the start of that film, George Méliès was around the turn of the last century. So that film, I believe, was 1901, 1902, something like that, which is just crazy, right at the dawn of cinema. And George Méliès, as I say, born in Paris, and he was walking by an advert for a magic lantern show one day. So he went into this shop, checked out what was going on in this exhibition, and he saw wonders in front of him. Now, he was a theatre owner, and the display he saw was just a curiosity. It was just demonstrating the technology, and he thought of ways to create special effects in plays, etc. Things that could be done on film that couldn't be done in real life. And he was the first person ever to do that. And here's one of his demonstrations of a special effect. This is from a 1902 film called The Man with the Rubber Head. He came up with the best titles. Have a look at this. See if you can tell how he actually created this special effect. All right, I will be quizzing you later.
Produced The Man with the Rubber Head, using black backgrounds and double takes on the same film. In the first take, Méliès moves forward on the dolly. His head, seen against the black background, seems to get bigger. Only the scenery around the background and Méliès himself blowing up his own head is caught on the film, and this is the result when the two takes are combined.
There you go. Nice to know more technology. So you're going to be seeing a few Méliès films tonight, but another man you're going to be seeing a lot of tonight is Mr. Dave Bainbridge.
Hello. It's got to get organised here. Right, how many of you were here last time that I was here? Oh, excellent. Excellent. So I played here, I think, 2012 with my band Iona, and yeah, that was a really good night. Incidentally, just as a matter of interest, how many people here are called Paul Bielatowicz?
Two. See, I beat you by two.
How many people are here are called Dave Bainbridge?
One.
The reason I ask is there is actually another Dave Bainbridge in the audience, so it was nice to meet you. I don't think we're related, at least not as, maybe hundreds of years previous. But yeah, tonight's going to be a mixture of music and film. We both have a passion for music and film, so there's going to be various styles of films, ranging from old to contemporary, and some also artwork as well, not just moving pictures. So I'm going to play an Iona piece. This was a track I wrote for an album called Book of Celt. Which was an 8th century illuminated manuscript of the four Gospels, led back to it. It's in Trinity College, Dublin, and it's an amazing piece of art. And it, apparently it took about 30 years to complete this amongst working just in cells on the island of Iona, which is an island of the coast of Scotland, as some of you already know. So this is Luke. incidentally, the artwork on here isn't from the Book of Kells. Oh, yeah, Mary Fleeston is a contemporary kind of calligrapher, and she's a friend of mine. She lives on the island of Lindisfarne with her husband, and sits all day and produces this incredible artwork. So she kindly loaned me slides. I'm going to do something completely different. This is, well, it's actually part of its original Iona, part of its traditional jigs, but we just call this jigs. And last time we were here, there was a little girl called Maddie who came up and danced to this. So, this is, she's not here tonight, she's not a little girl anymore now. She's 18 or
something. Teaching others how to do it.
Yeah, it's incredible, yes. So anyway, this is jigs with a bit of improvisation at the beginning. This is my band for the evening.
Thank you.
Yeah, back over to Paul. We will be doing some things together at some point during the evening.
I see. Well, are we doing something together?
Oh, actually, in fact, yeah, in fact, we are.
Sounds like a great idea.
Yes.
So, I have a page on a platform called Patreon, and basically this platform is a way for people to follow along with me, and it's like a subscription thing and get to see what I do every day. But I've got 173 patrons on there right now, and I've said the first 200 patrons that sign up, people that sign up, I am going to write them their very own composition. Crazy idea. What was I thinking? I didn't think it through, but I just kind of blurted it out, and now I've got to keep my promise. But anyway, this is a composition that I wrote for some patrons. This is called the First Snow, because when I was first going to their house, it was snowing for the first time in the season. And both me and Dave thought it would fit a film, a British animation film, called The Snowman, very well. So here is the first snow set to The Snowman. Thank you.
strange noises coming from?
Well, you should answer that. I thought you should wonder that, though. These strange noises are MIDI guitar, well, MIDI sounds, just MIDI synthesizer sounds. And what's going on with my pedalboard is I've got a send when I want it to go to my laptop. It triggers lots of keyboard sounds, so... translated by the software in my computer, so it means I can double keyboard parts, and stuff. You'll see later. Yeah, future is here.
One of the things about those early silent movies, as you probably know, is that at the time they couldn't sync music to the films, they didn't have the technology, so they often had live musicians accompanying the films. And in fact, I'm old enough that my first piano teacher, when I was about eight, was when he was in his 20s, he was actually an accompanist at a cinema. This was back in probably mid-1920s. And he played the organ, and it came up out of the floor and everything. And he accompanied all the popular films of the day. So it's quite ironic, like 100 years later, that I'm just about to attempt a similar thing. I've always loved improvising, and I've always loved films and the interaction between the two. So I'll be doing some more later as well, but this one... Oh, actually, this isn't one of the films, is it? No, that's later. Oh, I should have read my set list. Okay, anyway, that's an introduction for a song that's going to come later. But I am going to do an improvisation, yeah. right. This is only our second night on the tour. Actually, for this one, I'm going to improvise around some illustrations for the album I did a few years ago called Celestial Fire. And there was some amazing artwork from a guy from Belarus, called Ed Unitsky. And so you're going to see some of his illustrations and his digital art. And I'm going to try and kind of, if my neck doesn't give up looking like that, I'm going to try and interpret that in music. Thank you. built that image at the end. It's a kind of multi-layered thing. various Christian symbols in there. The dove, the hook, which is the Holy Spirit, and right up at the top you can see, kind of embedded in the picture, is Christ on the cross, and it's and then someone in front with their arms outstretched. Really interesting image. Lovely. So back over to you, Paul. I think.
All right. Yeah, we had a projector malfunction.
Oh, did we?
Well, it was droopy. All right. Well, I'm going to carry on with it. I do play over other people's films as well, but I'm going to do another film by Méliès, and this is a really quite a beautiful film. I really like this. It's called The Eclipse, and Méliès, as I say, was around the turn of the last century, lived and worked in Paris, France, at exactly the same time as Debussy, and I got to thinking, wouldn't it be cool if they would have collaborated? Now, there's no record of them even ever meeting. They must have been aware of each other. They were famous artists at the top of their fields, their respective fields, but there's no record of them ever meeting. So, until today, in Ames, Iowa, they're going to meet right here, right now, and collaborate on a film called
Thank you.
Yes, true. Well, in fact, there's going to be two films. First one is Méliès' film that I was asking Paul if he had something light-hearted that I could play to last week, and so he showed me this film. I thought it was absolutely brilliant.
That's why I suggested that.
So. Yeah. Yeah, isn't that brilliant? Anyway, so the second film. So I'm going to do these two contrasting films. The first one is a Méliès film. The second one is a contemporary film that a couple of my friends directed and did the animation for. Yeah, David Bunting, who was involved in the animation, worked on, you probably heard Wallace and Gromit. Have you seen Wallace and Gromit? Yeah, oh good. They have that in America. Good, excellent. But he didn't work on that, but he did work on Shaun the Sheep, which is the same Nick Parks, Aardman films. So that's more in the kind of style where you have models moving around. But I thought it was a fantastic moving story, so I wanted to have a go at coming up with a soundtrack for that as well. So here we go. Yes, Méliès first, yeah. Thank you.
Here's a film that Dave told me about. This film, he said, go check it out. And so I checked it out on YouTube, and this was the only autoplay after it. And it's a really mesmerizing, beautiful little animation from Australia called The Maker. And I'm going to play some Debussy to it.
Thank you.
tell you more about it, but yeah, intriguing. What do you do?
Nice. I'm going to play part of probably the longest tune that we wrote when I was in Iona, which is called Songs of Ascent. And it, originally it was a 22-minute suite, but thankfully for you, I'm not going to play it all. but I'm going to play the second part of it. This is Songs of Ascent, part two. And some of the imagery, the lady Mary Fleeson, who did the amazing calligraphy earlier on, she actually took... these films and photos of the island that she lives on, Lindisfarne. And it was on Lindisfarne, really, that the band Iona was born. So a long story, but anyway. So, in fact, actually, there is an interesting thing, because on this film, there's you get to see the Crown Inn, which is a little pub that does bed and breakfast. And when we formed the band Iona, we went up in December. We went up to Lindisfarne for a photo shoot, and in December it's freezing cold. It's very touristy in the summer, but in winter there's no one there. So my friend Dave, who was in the band, he rang up this place, the Crown Inn, and asked if we could have a couple of rooms to, because we were going to come up and do a photo shoot, and he mentioned we were a band, and he could hear their ears prick up on the other end. Musicians. And so anyway, they didn't say anything else. We got up there, and there was posters all over the island saying concert tonight. And the advertisers is doing a gig in the pub. So we were kind of stuck, and they locked the doors so we couldn't get out. And there was loads of people, loads of locals turned up. There was an upright piano which was out of tune. It was Joanne who sang. And David, he had some tin whistles with him. So we had to entertain this crowd for a whole night. So we ended up doing, we had about 8 Iona tunes at the time, so we'd only just recorded the first album. So we just ended up playing anything we could think of, like themes from TV series and all kinds of stuff. But it went down really well, and I think the drunker that the audience got, the more well-received we were. And at about 3 o'clock in the morning, they opened the doors and we managed to escape. But that was quite fun. So you see a glimpse of that, the Crown in this. This is, and it's got nothing to do with this really. This is Songs of Ascent, part two. Thank you. Thank you. And, we do something together now.
Oh! Yes. Oh, do. Could we lock the doors, please? I am about to sing, so I don't want anybody to escape.
He's off the roof.
Yeah, first. So, as some of you will know, I play in a band with Carl Palmer from Emerson, Lake and Palmer. And we do instrumental versions of ELP stuff without vocals. It's all instrumental. I thought I should do something about that. So I bought myself a vocal processor, voice processor, and you're going to be my guinea pig tonight. I'm going to inflict upon you my voice, and we're going to play a song called Lucky Man. And Lucky Man has got an iconic Moog solo recorded by Keith Emerson. And the story goes that ELP were recording the first album. Keith wasn't in the studio when they recorded Lucky Man, so it was just Carl and Greg. And then he had a delivery of the brand new synthesizer of the day, the Moog synthesizer. Easy for me to say. What he did, he was just playing around. They had the backup, the track on in the background, and he was just noodling around on this Moog synthesizer. And Greg said to Carl, or the other way around, hit the chord. Let's capture this. And so they recorded him noodling around at the end of the song. And he was horrified that they had captured what he thought was nonsense. But it's the most avant-garde, strange, wonderful solo. And I believe it's the first recording of a Moog synthesizer. And they kept it, and it stayed on the album. So Dave is going to improvise his own version of that. So here is Lucky Man. Yeah. So hey, yeah.
Thank you.
You're all still here.
All right, this is one of my favourites. Guess what? Who is by the film? This is another Méliès film. And this is his most famous film, 1902. And this is absolutely astoundingly groundbreaking. This is his A Trip to the Moon. And this is Méliès' first real attempt at doing kind of a narrative with throwing special effects in and all of that stuff, and you know, not just kind of trick films. But certainly, you know, he was doing it before anybody else. So this is probably our first special effects sci-fi film. It's A Trip to the Moon. I thought it would be a fun idea. Being a fan of play on words, I thought it would be a fun idea to play some Beethoven on the top of it. And so, tonight, we're going to give to you. You ready, Dave?
No.
I won't spoil the surprise. Let me tell you a little bit.
Yeah, good.
Yeah?
All right.
No need to film. All right, so tonight, we are going to meet you. Wait, slow down. A Trip to the Moonlight Sonata. Oh, yeah. I'm a funny guy.
How on earth do you play that? I have no idea. Just incredible. So we've come to the end of the evening. We're going to play one more tune that might be familiar to one or two of you who know Iona's music. This is Castle Rig and the Reels. So thanks for coming along. I know there's not a huge audience, but you've been very appreciative and we've loved it. So thank you.
Thank you so much for coming. And unless you'd like us to try something else next time.
Oh, yes.
Me and my big man. Would you like to get one more? Bear with us on this one. It's the LP classic. It is by my Hatch. It is from the brain salad surgery. And
we must be crazy trying to attempt this without a drummer.
Yeah, well, we're going to try it. It is Carnival on the Run. First impression, part two, complete with your guest vocalist here trying to sing it. So here it is, Carnival Night. Program the sounds to this. For you guys earlier, it was me programming these sounds. So yeah, so this, as I say, from the album Brain Salad Surgery, and what an amazing, whenever we play hard rock casinos and things like that, it's always a really good feeling to walk through the door and this the words "Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends," right above us. Right above the door as we walk in. So pretty iconic song. Let's do it. Let's do it.
Even though the words are pretty strange.
It's prog. And what the first sound he was messing around with, it's a preset in it. I'm like, oh my word, should we? And maybe we shouldn't have done that. Okay, there you go. Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. We're so glad you could attend. Come inside, come inside.
Thank you.
Good stuff, just out the front, and we're going to be out there waiting to chat to you, looking forward to saying hello, so we'll meet you out there. All right, guys.
All right.